my first ride back on my own today, and the weather is horrendous. But I'm still going to go out, give it a go. Quick local spin up to Crag Quarry, maybe Lee Quarry, see how I feel at the top.
So one of the things about getting back into your riding after you've had an injury or time off for whatever reason is that first hill. It's an absolute nightmare before you do it, nightmare when you do it. But once it's out of the way, you feel a bit good, don't you? But this is the start of the hill that will take you up to Green Booth, Crag Quarry and Lee Quarry. It's about 1,000 foot climbing over about 4 or 5 miles. It looks nice now, but it turns as cobbles around this corner, then rocks, then more rocks, then dirt and rocks, then mud and rocks. So let's get this one out of the way.
So about halfway up this climb, 774 feet of elevation in the climb, I'm about 1,074 feet above sea level at this point. Quick tip for you, never judge your ride on looking out your window. So if the weather looks all right out the window, it's not gonna look great outside when you get to 1,000 feet potentially. So this is what I'm looking at now. Oh, what are these gloves? Well, £6 off Amazon, 100% waterproof, fleece lined. Didn't get them just because they're orange. What a bargain if you're after some cheap gloves. It's always good to have a spare pack, spare pair in your pack anyway, but for £6 you could get a couple of pairs of these.
I can usually ride this at a decent pace, but the first ride back on my own, I'm taking everything super, super safe and slow and gentle, and it is a little bit slippy, as you might be able to see as well.
As you know, if you see my other Crag Quarry videos, it's windy up here and the conditions are less than ideal, so I don't know where to avert or carry on.
Trouble is you can't see what's under the snow. Come on, no.
Another great tip is if you're riding a trail that you ride a lot, try and find some bailout points as you get used to the trail, if it's your local or something. I mean, for me, I've done 2 minutes of that trail and it's like, oh, I've had enough. Oh.
Not as bad as I was thinking.
At this point, I've got a few options. I can go down that way. So I've just climbed out the back of Crag Quarry, that's Crag Quarry down there. And there's one great descent that takes you down to Green Booth, or I can head down the road here, around there to that windmill over that you can see on the camera. Not that one, over there.
So to get to that descent, you have to swing a left here. You'll see there's two black arrows, kind of don't look back on ourselves. But I will leave a link to the Strava segment if I can find it. Things to watch out for on this descent, it is quite straight and all right at first, a bit bumpy, and then there is a left turn you need to get. If you get it wrong, you're going to be a bit of a mess. It's off camber, it's probably going to fall with snow today. These brakes are going to get a warm up, I'm sure. Oh, it's boggy. That's slippy as well. You can see. It's alright actually, isn't it? Nope. Oh, it's a bit slippy now. Alright, there's a left turn coming up in a second. So you want to just slow it down a little bit here. Taking the high line, you get stuck in that gully. It makes it difficult. I need to drop into it actually. Get out of here, and then if you can get over this rock, which I'm not going to make it today, that puts you in a good line on this left side. And then, again, don't get stuck in that gully. And then you can go straight to the right, but we're going to swing it back to the left. Motocrossers love this. I stayed on just dab though. If you're in smell-o-vision, you smell my brakes now. This is tricky again. Not quite wide off your pedals. Make sure you get good. Okay. Now this, I don't actually know where this one goes. I presume it goes to the corner and back down. So it's an old school hiker bike. You can see a trail over there. Just get into it and then see where that one starts. Feel it. Wow, that's slippery ass. It's deep as well. I don't know how I go in that ditch. Which means it's no good for your pedals. Feel it, feel it, stop. Feel it. Oh, saved it. I think you can class that as a prolonged dab. I've got my foot into the pedal. Oh God. It's a bit deadly. The tyres are useless. On the edge there. Oh. That could be sketchy. I'll just pull to the side of it. Big enough for your tyre. Sloppy enough to catch you out. But not big enough for your pedals. Oh. Crap. It's not my most successful explore, this one. Again, pedal bashes. Yeah, that looks alright. I think it's got potential in the dry. So this is Upper Naden, Greenbooth. It's like down the side of it, down. It's quite fun. You just have to watch out for pedestrians at the bottom because it's a tight turn. If you get it wrong, you're going to get wet. You can do a little jump halfway down if you want. Whee! Get some air there. Oh, bit of slide there. See around it pretty well. Spot of lunch, nuts, butter, triple decker. Urban Dictionary would call that something else. Oh, it's out of date. Oh, it'd be all right. I'm heading to the other descent. I'm not going to stop, I'm going to go straight in because it's freezing now. It's a big old pedal back up there. So I feel a bit tired now to start because it's super, super boggy. Just drop it here. And there's a few nasty humps that can catch you out, so you have to just watch out. Looks like it's been a bit ragged by the motorbikes. How's this gonna go? First gear warrior. That's alright. Again, watch out for the start bit. Once you get past this start bit, it's a lot better. There is a little drop around here somewhere. Keep your eyes out for it. Maybe it's here. Oh, yeah, that's one. I think there's another one here, although you can mess this up, but I'll make an attempt at it. So we go down here, we'll swing a right into a little ditch. Is this a little drop as well?
Yeah.
Oh, crap. Nah, I can roll that. So we go down here, there's going to be a right turn, you can probably see down there. Just in and out, dead easy. Rolls well. Quick look first, make sure of the change. Need through. It's a bit flowy for a bit. You can get a bit of speed, so watch out. Oh, I like that one. Drop into the rut again. The right hand side is usually better up here. Oh, he says, I'm sliding. Oh, that was nasty. Oh, there is a big hole on the right here. If you want to, oh, sugar. Glad the ram was scared of me. If you want to try and take this to the right if you can. There's a big hole there. This is just a bit gentle way of getting down. What gear am I in? Need an easier gear for this bit. This is slippy, sliding. There's rocks under it. You do need a bit of speed to get up the other side. It's a bit too slippy today. Ugh. When you get here, there's a right turn. Just chilling, not going for any PRs today. There's an alternate line on the left, which is fairly new. Not tried that one. Ugh. Spin it. There's two left ones now. I'm going to try this one because it looks new. Ooh, it's slippy. I have to take it steady. You never know if there's going to be a drop at the end of something. It just looks more like the natural line. Goodness me. Oh, it's a motorbike line again. It's horrible. Is there an alternate or am I going to be pushing down here? Oh, that is mashed. Maybe dance under me the bike. Pull the brake pads down.
So the first solo mountain bike ride, it's been quite a success. The The weather was horrible, which made it more of an achievement. And it almost felt like a bit of a mental fight to get out the door with the horrible weather and riding on your own. I got up too late to ride with the other guys. And it's been all right. Confidence isn't quite there yet. There's a few stupid mistakes you probably see earlier in the video. But I survived and I was taking it pretty steady today. Overall then, good ride. Thanks for watching. I'm going to head home now. The hardest bit is going to ride past the chippy without buying anything. And yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.
Thank you.
Cheers.